Hello, it's nice to have you folks back here at Murphy's Welcome to My World. This time we're going to be building a 170-foot Howe Bridge from the nice folks at the Hunterline Company. And this is a picture that comes with the packaging. Let's hope mine comes out just as good. Now the instructions that come from the Hunterline Companies are always very inclusive. It tells you the story behind the item. When it comes, it just looks like a bunch of sticks and little bags. What can I do with all this stuff? My personal favorite part of the instructions are the blueprint type, easy for me to say, drawings, and I use them actually as a building template. I place double-sided tape right onto the templates, and then I start building the items from the bottom up. Of course, anytime you're going to be having repetitive, accurate cuts, the only thing I have is the chopper 2. It's the only way to get a very consistent set of parts. Okay, on to construction. As you see, I'm laying down the roadbed here. And utilizing this idea of the blueprints, you can literally just build one piece right on top of the other and get it exactly the way that they wanted you to get it. And you'll see there's these other parts, these cords that I'm putting together. They have little tiny spacers in them. And you can't have too many handy helpers. I have weights and clips and rubber bands and all kinds of stuff. Now as you're moving along, once the glue's dry, make sure to clean up all the parts and make sure they fit correctly. These little blocks here, these have to be very accurately placed or else the rest of your kit's going to be difficult. And I can't overemphasize getting these back and forth supports as accurately placed as possible, because it'll really come back to haunt you later if you don't. So you start building the box. This is one of the more difficult parts for me anyway, is to get these cross members that hold up the road bed. So take your time, get them correct the first time around. Then you lay the road bed in there. Now it's actually starting to look like something. It's starting to look like a bridge. It's amazing how strong these are. The tedium is drilling all the little holes, because you have these metal supports that hold the bridge together. Then you have to feed all these metal supports in through those little holes you just drilled. It's rather tedious. But then all of a sudden, just like that, it's done. And it's amazing how strong this model is. Obviously, the original bridges were every bit as strong as this one was. I decided to color this bridge with an alcohol-based stain. It took the stain exceptionally well. And here you see the finished bridge put in a little diorama that I built specifically for it. These kits from the Hunterline Company, I've built a number of them, and every one of them have been just such good fun. So you might look into this 170-foot Howe Bridge from the nice folks at the Hunterline Company, and you'll be happy you did. I certainly was, and I'm looking forward to the next one. Thanks for the fun, guys. Bye.